and A. Sometimes you can represent it as A like that, right? Followed by small a. If you change where A, where you begin with A, then it is multiplying the bigger A. This one, irregardless, it's just one, if you're looking at it in terms of appearance. It's just one and the same. So it's A by A, it gives you A squared. You get it? You can write it down, you can derive it. You can say A by A, the other one, A by plus A by A, the other one, and you solve that bracket. You're going to get to A. So now if we add the total that is here, that is the total population of genes that we have in a population, represented by this graph. So you might find that there will be a certain degree of homozygous being expressed, certain degree of heterozygous genes being expressed, and a certain level of recessive genes being expressed. So as a breeder, you have a target. What do you want to produce? Maybe you want to produce this. So your work is to try and reduce this type of genes as much as possible. Hey guys, please pay a bit of it. So maybe your target is to get this type of gene being expressed more. So your target is to try and remove in the crossing or back crossing. You can use back crossing to generate this. So that your population will have more of this frequency being expressed. Or if you have a population that is demonstrating a lot of heterozygous, sometimes this is where we start as breeders. You get varieties out there that are still heterozygous in various ways, but they are genes that you are targeting to get out of them. So your idea is to self them until the dominant genes that you are looking for or recessive genes that you are looking for are expressed, and until you get a pure line. So you are either targeting, your breeding program is either targeting for you to go to the far left where you get the homozygous dominant trait if it is of interest, or you are going to the far right where you get the homozygous recessive trait. You don't want your genes, frequency of your genes to be in this middle level. So you can calculate in a population how much of P, what is the frequency of P in a population? What is the frequency of 2PQ, which is represents the heterozygous, or what is the frequency of Q squared, which represents the recessive in a population? So that frequency tells you that, oh, okay, if it is at this level, then my species that I have, or the population I have, is now expressing more of this. But of course, you relate it to the phenotype that you are observing, because you must observe. If the gene of interest is recessive and is observable in the phenotype, you are going to then be able then to calculate, based on the population, how many are expressing this.
Are we warming up? Are we warming up?